Hello, I'm Mr. Harmandir, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, a scientist. And I learnt Christianity, the New Testament, I studied in 1983. I wrote the exposition of Matthew. And this parable, Matthew 19, was not coming first correct. But when I start writing it down, the correct interpretation came in by the grace of our Supernatural Father. So this parable is a test for the people who are twice born. The once born people cannot understand this one. So if you can follow me, not follow blindly, but if you make effort to study along with me, then you might get the answer what is written. But this answer is not a simple one. That is why here Jesus said, "Those who have ears, let them hear." So the Holy Gospel of our Supernatural Father Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc., delivered by the First Anointed Christ, which in Punjabi we call Satguru, Jesus, of the highest living God, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc., that dwells within our temple of God, called Harmandir, or Emmanuel, God is with us, according to Saint Matthew 19, verse 3 to 12. So this is the temple of God, not made by human hand, but by the Lord of the nature, Yahweh, Brahma, Khuda, the potter. And for the potter of the physical body, apply the moral law. So, in before Jesus, we used to have a teacher of the moral law, rabbis, Pharisees, Sadhus, who were teaching them the moral of Moses to create a kingdom of heaven, which you can see outside in law and order. But John the Baptist, he was the last prophet. Luke 16, verse 16, law and prophets were till John the Baptist. So no law, no transgression, no sin. But it is the era of blasphemy now. Blasphemy comes from your own heart and it is very destructive. As you can see what Tony Blair and Bush did in Iraq. There were no weapons of mass destruction, but they made it that there are weapons of mass destruction, and for hypocritically, they destroyed the country. A military major general, Rudy Porter, he went to the Iraq after the destruction or during the war, and he gave us a sermon in Reading. And people asked him whether Saddam Hussein has weapons of mass destruction. He said, definitely no. So what came out of the mouth of Tony Blair and Bush? That was blasphemy. Blasphemy, which is not forgivable. So look what they have done. One country after the other, they destroyed it. And they start destroying with Iraq, the birthplace of the forefather of the chosen people, Abraham. That he was the cradle of humanity, Iraq. And the first thing they did, they destroyed the very place of their forefathers, these messianic, these Jews, you know, they destroyed it. America is ruled by Mammon and media. America is Israel in disguise. So you will see a lot of things happening, and people are awakening, and recently you will see them. The people will be killing and hating them in different countries, and they will be running to Israel for bundling up. And for the final burning, expected in atomic war, which will take place on 14 May 2023, when Israel is 75 years old. Donald Trump pressed the button of tribulation on 14 May 2018, and making Jerusalem to be the capital of Israel, making it a mercy to move to Jerusalem. You will see these people will be soon occupying the whole promised land, Iraq and all this West Bank and this and that. All the promised land will be occupied by the chosen people, the Jewish people, the tares. Matthew 13 verse 24 to 30 is getting fulfilled. Let's carry on with this parable. Some Pharisees, the teacher of the moral laws, who are supposed to be Matthew 13 verse 52, they are the owner of a house, synagogue, who bringeth for treasures old and new. Old are scripture, and the new are his word, the oral Torah. But oral Torah knowledge was missing among them. So they were applying dead letters. And that's why tragedy came. And then he faced these hypocrites. Remember that John the Baptist is here. So John the Baptist is here, Munn, a witness to the light, not the light. So John the Baptist is like our skin here, this one, outside, Munn. This moonlight applied to this one. The sunlight applied to our soul. And this is the royal kingdom of God, which Christ Jesus bringing. So here we have saint. The saint are solitary virgin bride of Christ Jesus, the bridegroom. And here are the disciple of the John the Baptist. Perfect in the moral law, they are called angels or angels. Perfect in the scripture knowledge, they are called saint. So angel and saint here. So John the Baptist was the last angel. So why Jesus came on the virgin birth? Because they had become, here is Adam, under races, tribes, and then surnames and other things. No Jew or Hindu or Sikh. They became Jew outwardly. They became Jew outwardly here. And when they became Jew outwardly, they could not build their covenant to Abraham. Because Abraham was Semitic race outwardly. Otherwise the Ishmael people, the Egyptian, they too would have been Jew. It was a scripture, it was not the scripture itself. So Hindu, Sikh, Muslim, Jew, etc., they are all scripture self. Never born, never die. But the sons of Satan, they exploit people. Now let's see. Some Pharisee approached Jesus and testing him, saying, "Is it lawful for a man to divorce his wife for any cause whatsoever. Now these Pharisees, Sadducees, they are the moral teacher. Matthew 30 verse 52 was the ideal rabbi or the ideal Pharisee Sadducee. But they were lacking the knowledge of the Oral Torah. Oral Torah is his word. And that Jesus came to deliver. And they hated him. They killed him. They loved darkness, not the light. So that's why they are saying, can we divorce our wife for any reason? You know, no question asked. Question asked based upon the moral laws. But Jesus was the scripture preacher to our conscience called mind, nafs in Arabic, and Munn in Punjabi. That means to our soul, which is the spiritual self, not the physical self, like the moral teachers. He said in reply, so here Jesus is describing the scripture marriage between soul, which is the supernatural self of our supernatural father, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm. Soul is the representation of it, that means the son of Allah, or Elohim, or Parbrahm. He said in reply, have you not read that from the beginning the creator, demiurge, which is Yahweh, Brahma, Khuda, they say the created by Yahweh, Brahma, Khuda. So Jesus was the son of Yahweh. That's why the angel told him to give him the name Yeshua, made of two words, Yah from Yahweh, Shua or Shiva means the primal Adam. So Jesus was the firstborn of Yahweh, the second Adam. Mary was surrogate mother and Joseph foster father. Sorry. Namely, Yahweh Brahma Khuda, the potter, this pot was made by him. Made them male and female in flesh. Different gender, you know, because Pharisee, Sadducee, they dealt with flesh, and Jesus dealt with our supernatural self, mind, in flesh. A simile established for the scripture analogy, and said, for this reason, a man is our soul, because the representation of the father is man, boy, and not the girl. Girl doesn't have any seed. So the man is soul, representing our supernatural father. So the woman is universal, like God is, they have no boundary, so they have no boundary. Made them male and female in flesh. He simply established for spiritual analogy and said, for this reason a man, soul of our supernatural self, shall leave his father, God, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc., and mother, Holy Spirit, called Mahadevan in India, Punjab. Remember that Gobind, Sache Pasha, the royal king Gobind, Raiji, who became Singh later on, he represented God, and he has his consort, which was called Mahadevan. Mahadevan means the Shakti of the highest order. So the Shakti of our God, Father, is the Holy Spirit. Through Holy Spirit we know our supernatural Father. Without Holy Spirit we cannot know Him. Holy Spirit is small s is common sense. Holy Spirit is capital S is extraordinary sense of our supernatural Father. Leave with Father, God, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc. And Mother, Holy Spirit called Mahadevan in Punjabi. And he joined to his wife. Wife is the mortal flesh. This is mortal flesh. Born and died. The soul is never born, never died, because it returns back to our supernatural Father to give account. And the two, soul plus flesh, on conception of a woman, you know, that is what applies to flesh, the opposite applies to spirit. So, in the marriage of the man and a woman in flesh, you can see it with your naked eye in the church or anywhere else. But this one is not opposite, this is hidden in here in the stomach on conception. So, flesh on conception shall become one flesh, one person to his wife. One person, whether male or female, in flesh, you know, whether you are a male or a female, but you will be one person, which is created by the union of soul from our supernatural Father, called man, because it dominates your body. And then the flesh is the female, which is demiurge. And so without a soul, it's dead. Flesh and the two, soul plus on conception, shall become one flesh, person, whether male for water, or the tribal seed, alright, or female represents God for blood. Remember when a child is born, the blood comes from the girl and the water, semen, come from the man. So blood is the life. So woman is the life giver, representing God, whereas the man who is giving water, semen, he is the representation of Adam. So this planet Earth for the habitation of the sons of Adam, sons of man. And women, that's why they had no right to vote or other thing. But this is dark age. So this is the age of spirit, in which the woman and the man, they are alike, because soul in each of us is the same. Male or female, God for blood, so for blood is coming from woman, so she represents God, God's side. So they are no longer two, soul and his wife, flesh. Soul and his wife, flesh, physical body, but one flesh, person, whether he is a male or a female. Therefore, what God has joined together in the womb of the mother, no human being must separate or kill. As in the abortions. Remember, in the abortion, they are two, or they are separated or killed, which is a killing an innocent man, innocent person. And the beauty is that he goes scot-free. He's scot-free, whereas the person who killed it outside, another person, he's put in jail. Same is here. In Reading, we had a man who killed 3 people. He is a Libyan man. And he is put in jail. And they are going to put him in jail. And whereas Tony Blair and Bush, they spoke blasphemy that Saddam Hussein had weapons of mass destruction, which was hypocrisy. And they are going free. Nobody is catching them. They have planks in their own eyes. And this man has just a small splinter in the eye. So, man with his plank in his eye, he goes scot-free. The splinter man is caught. Many more such attacks will happen. By the people whose homes are destroyed, they have a grudge against these Europeans whose bombs destroyed them. So we are approaching the end of the age, because atomic war is expected on 14 May 2023. So a lot of things will happen. This virus is also of Yahweh, Brahma, Khuda, because the creation of Yahweh, they suffer when there is a war. So, no human being must separate or kill as in the abortions. They said to him, then, why did Moses command that the man give the woman a bill of divorce and dismiss her? He said to them, because of the hardness of your hearts, as Pharos was killing the newborn boys among the chosen people, and Moses allowed you to divorce your wife. But from the beginning is Satyug, we call it in Punjabi, in which all the 4 qualities are intact. In the time of Moses, the one quality was missing, which was mercy. That is why they were cruel and killing like that. So when the mercy was there, when there was another Pharaoh who was merciful, and there was no more trouble in the Egypt. But as soon as this Pharaoh came, merciless, he caused problem. That age is called Satyug, you know, when every 4 qualities are intact. Satyug, when all the people possess, most of the people possess, all the 4 religious qualities, which are, number 1, conscience of morality. Number 2, truth, they don't tell lies. Number 3, contentment. And number 4 is mercy, top of the age. So this mercy was missing, and then there were only 3 left. And that's why they were killing, and Pharaoh became merciless. It was not so. That means in the beginning it was not so. People loved each other. So, remember that in Egypt, the land of the Ishmael, they used to have hospitals at the time of Christ Jesus. Whereas in Jerusalem or Israel, there was none, because they were cruel, making more money, greedy people. And the Samaritan people, they are the generation of Joseph. And they were having that qualities of Joseph, which is the of Abraham. Because he was the one who was, they wanted to kill. And then they sold him as a slave to the Egyptian. Egyptian honored him for his qualities. And he became the head of the state. And then he treated his own people, special land and everything was given. But when they returned back to Israel, they kicked him in the face. They hated him and his generation. That is the quality of the saltless people. They have no conscience. As today, when they destroyed Iraq, Iraq is the birthplace of their forefather Abraham. So they started to destroy the humanity with Iraq. So you can see they are the tears, sons of the Most High Satan. And they are getting bundled up in Israel for final burning. Matthew 13, verse 24 to 30 is getting fulfilled. So at the times of Moses, the quality mercy had gone. I say to you, whoever divorces his wife as Saul did to Gamaliel. So Saul, you know, he gave his body to Gamaliel, or he became the disciple of Gamaliel. The root of the word disciple is discipline. And these moral teachers, they discipline their disciples by teaching them the moral of Moses. So this Saul came to learn of spirituality, and he landed in the hand of Gamaliel. And in India too, you know, when a student go to study from Brahman, he used to cut small bit of head here and put it under his seat, that you are now my student, you obey what I tell you to do. So mercy, it was not so. At the time of Moses, the quality mercy had gone. I say to you, whoever divorces his wife, as Saul did to Gamaliel, and many today do so to the Antichrist Pope, Bishop. They do what a bishop tells them to do, or the Pope tells them to do. So, etc. They put under bracket, you know, this thing, that unless the marriage is unlawful, which they have, men of dead letters have put this thing, it is wrong, you know, it is corruption. They don't understand this parable. So, not unless the marriage is unlawful, it is not correct. And marries another, or makes once born spiritually blind disciples, as Pope has done. So people who are spiritually blind, they become the disciple of their clever crooks, you know. He commits adultery. So the person who makes disciple, he commits adultery, as Gamaliel had done. As he cannot give their accounts to God. So, after the Damascus Gate experience of Christ coming to his heart, Christ coming to the heart of Saul to set him free of the clutches of Gamaliel, his wife, Saul, was spiritually remarried, the soul of Saul, married the soul of Saul. Soul has no name, you know, soul is known by the physical body, this name. And that soul has no spirit, no name. But apply to flesh the opposite to spirit. Soul of Saul remarried her, the flesh, that he depressed, you know, which was Saul, and he gave the new name, Paul, as a married woman divorces, as many women divorced by her husband would get another surname on remarrying again, or on marrying again. When she marry again, then she is called Mrs. So-and-so, say Mrs. Smith. When she marry Mr. Taylor, then she become Mrs. Taylor. So her surname changes. In this age of Christ, which you need to be solitary, as everyone is to give his own account to God. So in this age you have to be solitary, everyone has to give his own account to God. So you can't make any disciple in the name of Christ Jesus or anything. You are free, you set other people free, not to enslave them. These hireling doctrinal priests in the churches today, but in the churches when they created the Messianic Jews, they created these churches and also the Antichrist. You remember the parable of the wine press? That is Jerusalem temple. And the wine press, they were producing a low quality wine, or corrupt wine, no good for anything. And so that's why Jesus came to rip them off. So in Jesus, everyone has to give his own account to God. So nobody can stand between man and God. You have to direct approach to God through His Word. Through His Word. So if you are not capable of understanding through His Word, which is logo or end product of logical reasoning, you cannot know God. Come to God. These hireling dog collar priests in the churches, they are antichrist. So they are antichrist, you know. Fulfilling Matthew 12, verse 43 to 45, making the situation worse than for the arrival of Jesus. An example is Ireland. In India also, it was kept and Muslim and all that. The British people, they did saltless British people did their mischief. So in Ireland, Catholic and Protestant fighting against each other. In Jesus, we have one fold, Church of God, one shepherd, right Jesus. So the talker of faith, people have no place in the ministry of Christ Jesus. They can't give their account to God. The rabbi used to give their account to God at Passover. So his twice born brethren and not the once born disciples. The root of the word disciple is discipline. You discipline through moral laws. And in Jesus we don't have moral law, we are free, like the sadhus in the jungle. So we don't have disciple in Christ Jesus. So rabbis, disciple of the rabbis said to him, if that is the case of a man with his wife, it is better not to marry. He answered, not all can accept this word, but only those to whom that is granted by the grace of our Supernatural Father. You can't have His word without His grace. So you have to make your face turn to God, and then you get this thing. And here is an example. What happens when you turn your face to God? Here is the royal kingdom that Jesus came to establish. This is John the Baptist. Those Jewish people, you know, realize that when they become Jew outwardly, our physical self, they break their covenant with Abraham. Because Abraham was of Semitic race. So they came to John the Baptist to be baptized in the name of Abraham. And he baptized Jesus in the name of his Heavenly Father Yahweh. So that's why his name was Yeshua. Yeshua meaning the primal Adam. So those people who came to John the Baptist to be baptized in water, they were mostly twice born. So he baptized them in the name of Abraham, and then he handed it over to them to Christ Jesus. And they being of Holy Spirit, they understood the gospel much better. So Jesus come from this side, above. This is below, this is above. So here is the royal kingdom of God, Elohim Allah Parbrahm, which belong to the Sadhus of the Melchizedek type. So here when you want to enter, you should not carry any money in your pocket. No two shoes, no tunic. And like Sadhu, you know, you should be contented with your lot. And don't worry about the material thing. Their faces are towards God, and their back is towards public. So before you can enjoy the food provided by Christ Jesus, which is His world, you must be twice born. So the people over here, they are twice born, who came to be baptized, and they entered through this narrow gate, which is meant for the solitary. So when they entered this one, then they looked up to Jesus, you know, and they turned their seed, tribal seed, into plant, and made the tribal identity implicit, explicit to us. Spiritual qualities. So here then John the Baptist handed them over, and they were seeking God. So that only the Christ can tell, because He is the Son of the Most High, Elohim Allah Parbrahm. So this is the royal kingdom of God, in which our soul is concerned, only souls of sadhus. Sadhus have no tribal identity. So that's why Jesus said some became eunuchs for the kingdom of heaven, which is in law and order. But you must have the knowledge of oral Torah if you want to be of heaven. So let's see. Not all can accept this word, but only those to whom that is granted by the grace of our supernatural Father. Some eunuchs, now Jesus here described eunuchs, you know, and that is also very interesting. Some eunuchs are incapable of marriage because they were born on They were born so. Some eunuchs born from the womb of the woman. And they are They are the natural bastards that are born of the prostitutes or the temple dancing girls called dasis in India, you know. So, yeah, I will remember John 8, verse John 8, you know, there was a woman caught in adultery brought to him to give judgment. But judgment is the regime of John the Baptist. Because in Christ he name don't judge anyone. So that's why he started, you know, then his own ministry after the baptism. He did a kind of 40 days of wilderness. And after that, when he started his own ministry. So, that is such natural bastards called mustard seed are not allowed to marry and reproduce more people with no tribal identity. So, such is he called mustard seed, you know. And Jesus was anointed mustard seed. And Jesus also entered this royal vineyard. Because he was possessed the very spirit of God, Holy Spirit with capital S. So he enjoyed his visit to the temple. Tribal, some, because they were made so by others. You know, sometimes people made others by others. As there are, these are the people who change their tribal identity for the sake of Mammon and also the temple priest for making them by making them chosen people, are the Jews outwardly by turning them Jews of appearance or outwardly and not inwardly spiritual of heart. So that's what they were doing. They were making disciples in the name of Christ Jesus. So they are themselves are dead, you know, spiritually dead, and they are the one causing problems. Heart. Some because they have renounced marriage as John the Baptist was born of Zechariah, but he was not given his tribal son. Remember when we were born and they wanted to know what surname we should give, we call him. Then he said John. He did not give him what is his tribal surname. Tribal surname. In order he could be the prophet Elijah. Prophets are under Adam, and saints are under Son. So we are the sons of the Most High, Elohim and Parbrahm. So we are dominated by Sun, primary source of light, and not by the secondary source of light, the Moon. So Prophet Elijah, my God is demiurge Yahweh. For the sake of the kingdom of heaven. And for the sake of the kingdom of heaven, which is, you can see in law and order, which is these two naked eyes. Royal kingdom of inside, kingdom of heaven outside. That's why the pilot, when he asked Jesus, what type of king you are? And then Jesus told him that if my kingdom was outside like this one, then my soldiers would have come to fight against your soldiers. But mine is of heart, within my heart, not outside. So the pilot understood it. So he told the Jews he has nothing done wrong to deserve death penalty. They wanted to release him, but he said no, no. He shouted more and more. And he had to then told them, okay, take him away and do your own justice. And he washed his hand in water under sun, that we have nothing to do with the blood of this man. So, for the sake of the kingdom of heaven, that you see in law and order, which is outside, royal kingdom of God is inside. An angel to establish law and order. In Jesus, his virgin brides became spiritual units like the Sadhus Melchizedek, the saint to preach the gospel. So they became saints, you know, when they became a solitary. The Sadhus do not carry any tribal identity or money or to know, they don't have two tunic or two shoes. Only one is enough for them. These sadhus do not carry any tribal identity, or they are no more under law. They can live naked in the wilderness, but not in the come in the city and be naked, you know. That is not allowed by the people. Whoever can accept this ought to accept it. So this is a difficult parable. And it's only known if you are man of spirit. Men of dead letters would not know this parable. And you see their own exposition, what they render, you know, to convince you that it could be this and that and that. So I live near Oxford University and I go there to tell them about these parables, but they are not interested, because they are drunk with the old wine of the dead letters. So, I don't know.